Since you bring up the point of a cultural sphere, being, you know, part of a political, cultural and educational space like, say, JNU, how do you see now the kind of cultural practices that, you know, student collectives are bringing up?
See, these are the, these kind of cultural practices outside the claimed cultural spaces is a very important initiative, and they are somehow exploring alternative means. Now, this alternative exploration of alternative means that there is no space for these kind of practices. So, therefore, you explore the alternative means, and it's through their political social movement somehow they are managing to create that kind of a space, and it is helping immensely because it is changing the perception of the public. And that plays an important role. Though it is being practiced only within the academic spaces, but there are people, there are cultural groups who are practicing it outside the academic domain, and they are constantly engaged in that. And therefore, these kind of cultural spaces are helping students, the creative artists, to think differently. Even biennales, which are being organized these days, they are creating all alternative spaces, and it's a good initiative.
How do you also see the plausibility of such practices as, say, possibly a response, you know, to those classic questions around where responses can possibly come from, around where these questions can be asked back to the mainstream and asked against a kind of native hegemony that's
been built up? See, the, for example, I'll just cite you an example of Dalit literature, Marathi Dalit literature. They decided, like, what Marathi you are talking about, we will challenge this Marathi. What is good Marathi, so-called Puneri Mumbai Marathi, cannot be a Marathi of the state and cannot be our Marathi. That is how people challenged. And then they started writing poetries. They started writing their life narratives and all, and there are a number of poems which have been written, beautiful poems, which the mainstream failed to produce. So, there is this challenge. The challenge comes through your consciousness by using the tool of formalism. The so-called idea of mainstream is a misnomer, because this misnomer has been created in order to maintain their own control. And that is how the Brahminical thinking goes. It will always think of their own power and their own space. Because there is a challenge, there is a political challenge, therefore you talk about the inclusiveness. But that inclusiveness, you do not want to take that part as something which is challenging you. You are okay type, you are giving some kind of a space. And that is why I always argued the whole Ambedkarite movement, in cultural movement in India, is not about space for articulation. It is all about power of articulation. Because the moment you talk about the space for articulation,
It is a co-optive something.
The moment you talk about the power of articulation, so there comes the challenge. And that challenge can only be, I mean, that challenge has to be done through various means. You cannot have just one singular thing. And therefore, like, the protected ignorance becomes a very, very conceptual tool to unfold the intentions that are there in the practices, in the thinking, in the consciousness. Ambedkar had said, you know, gulamu ko gulami ka ehsas dilao to wo jaag uthega. As long as you are in the perennial slavery of so-called fallacy of intellectualism, you will never question. And to me, postcolonial theory is a fantastic example of protected ignorance, because it has not killed ignorances at all. You blame Britishers for certain things, true, but what we have done since last 70 years, I am not saying that the artworks create revolution and all. These are the idiotic kind of ideas, those ideas. But whether your artworks, whether your art practices are clinging towards what kind of a political objectives, whether it is part of your Brahmanic modernity or it is challenging and creating a different kind of a space, opening up the possibilities of multiple strands of creativity, not just one.
Thank you for coming here with us today, Dr. Alone. This was a very valuable discussion. For more interviews and conversations like this, please log on to indiancultureforum.in.